Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to learn lesson 7, Too Late. Well, at the very beginning we'll see the title, Too Late. You can't imagine what it's going to tell us. Let me tell you, lesson 7, Too Late, is going to tell us a story between policemen and thieves. You know, when I was a boy, I preferred watching the TVs and plays about thieves and policemen, and funnily, policemen with guns killed all the thieves, da, 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 and they'll die. Well, policemen win. But I like that. Now, this text is going to give us quite different story. Finally, who won? You know that, thieves. So finally, thieves won, and the policemen failed the mission. Wow, that's why I love this story. Okay, 我们今天的第七课叫做太晚了，为时太晚。讲的什么故事呢？依旧是警匪的故事。我们小时候，尤其像楚老师小时候，特别喜欢看就是警匪片，拿着枪哒哒哒哒哒各种打人，最后把坏蛋打死，觉得不够解气，因为有时候觉得坏蛋还挺英勇的，怎么每次都坏蛋死呢？哎 ，Lesson Seven 第七课这个作者我很喜欢，你懂的，因为最终谁赢了呢 ？Yeah, the thieves， 贼赢了。所以我们来今天学这篇文章，是我个人非常喜欢的一篇文章，所以呢，这篇文章我会教大家如何当堂跟着我就把它给我复述出来，也就是背下来。你能做到吗 ？I can do, and then you can. 我能，你也可以。那么 Lesson 7叫 Too Late， 这篇作者的写作手法有一点非常颠覆传统。我们说平时这些警匪呢，都是以警察获胜为最终结局，就像我们很早以前 Long, long ago, there was a princess living in the castle. She was cursed.She came to the castle. She's waiting for her prince. 你看，所有童话故事一样，都在描述是一个在城堡里，一个美丽的公主在等待着王子来解救她。然后最后结局就是 finally they live together, happy forever. 哎，这个故事读起来也太 naive, 太幼稚了。所以呢，今天这篇文章作者就我们颠覆了传统。今天我们来看一下，到底为什么警察就失败了呢 ？OK, so first.第一步，跟着楚帅一起看动画，听故事。Are you ready? 准备好了吗 ？Let's go. International Airport. The plane was late, and detectives were waiting at the airport all morning. They were expecting a valuable parcel of diamonds from South Africa.Wow, diamonds. A few hours earlier, someone had told the police that thieves would try to steal the diamonds.When the plane arrived, some of the detectives were waiting inside the main building, while others were waiting on the airfield. Two men took the parcel off the plane and carried it.Into the customer's house. See? Well, two detectives were keeping guard at the door. Two others opened the parcel. To their surprise,The precious parcel was full of stones and sand. See? So finally, the policeman didn't save the diamonds, right? And of course, thieves stole them. Okay, so that's it. 好，我们刚刚通过这漫画呢，再次跟大家一起过了这个课文。那我们这课文基本上了解了。At the very beginning said, the plane was late. 所以你看这个文章 跟着楚帅一起来分析一下文章，我们来先来读懂它，看作者到底是怎么一笔一笔写下来的。首先呢，作者先给我们交代了一个非常非常大的一个 opening， 一个开始，就是跟读者说了 the plane was late， 就是飞机干嘛晚点了。哎呦，飞机特别晚点，而且我们特讨厌飞机晚点，飞机晚点就是等啊，所以第一句话特别好说，怎么说？ What 什么晚点来着？ The plane， right？ So the plane was late。We're waiting， 我们想 we're waiting， 当然等着了。那么所以说这个文章的描述呢，一开始的时候读者都会不小心陷入到这个里面去，因为这个文章是个倒叙的。他先说的是飞机晚点，然后说 detectives are waiting， 读者一头雾水，怎么突然跑出了 detectives 警察了呢？所以说我们这两个地方，一个是 the plane， 所以这里我们插入的是 plane， 飞机晚点。那么飞机晚点人就要等，但这里的人不是 passenger， 而是 detective， 所以这里我们插入的是 detective。 那名词其实这里已经给大家进入一个先入为主的一个小故事开端了。 The plane was late， detectives were waiting at the airport， 怎么着？ All morning， 等了很久，所以呢一个 all morning 这个来描述他们的不耐烦。那么所以其实读者通过第一句就会特别的有一点点 confused， 很疑惑，这个飞机晚点跟警探有什么关系呢？所以这是第一句作者的妙笔之处所在。所以各位同学在学习新二这篇文章的时候，你一定要入境，一定要去分析好这篇文章作者的写作手法和思路，而你在今后的写作当中也应该这样，不要开门见山。如果你是描述的一个非常非常普通的平凡的故事 OK， 但如果你描述的故事大家都听腻了的，比如说什么警察抓小偷，那真没意思，没人爱看。这就是一篇非常好的 story， 故事啊多半都是假的，所以都是在说假的。为什么我爱听他说的不爱听你说的呢？因为你说的太假，人家说这个 surprise 会给我惊喜。 OK， 我们一起来跟我重复一下楚老师。 OK， 跟楚帅重复一下。 OK， at very beginning the plane was late， 飞机晚点了，谁等？ detectives， 警探侦探。好，我们把这单词一起跟楚帅读五遍。好，侦探这个词我就作为男生都得会，包括我都会爱看那个日本动画片叫做 Conan， 柯南吧。 Conan is detective， 人家就是个侦探啊，所以这个侦探来跟着我念五遍。 Are you ready？ Detective， 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 非常好记单词。我们把它分成几音节来， D 一就发 D， 然后 T E C 发的是 D， 最后是 TIP 连起来 Detective。 好，我们重音跟着走啊， Detective， Detective。OK， once more， 再来一遍，好吧？飞机晚点怎么说？ The plane was late。 侦探呢就等了一上午。好，一上午怎么说？ All morning。 See， 所以第一句话你跟着我就已经顺下来了吧， No problem。 OK， 再来一遍，飞机晚点呢，这个警探就在哪儿等了一整早晨啊？啊，飞机等飞机哪儿啊？在机场了。所以机场怎么说？我觉得大家都会说了吧，你凡是学过英语的要是不会说机场你都太丢人了。来，机场怎么说？ Airport。 好，所以我们把整句连起来，我们把这个给大家引去哈。